Welcome to our mini lecture. Today, our topic will be interpretation of financial statements, and my name is Chinedu Anganeno. When we talk about interpretation of financial statement or financial analysis, we really need to understand that it's a skill and it's some kind of learning that we need to do to be able to get up to the stage where we can do an effective and an impactful financial analysis. This is a broad area, and I would like us to focus on the two major areas of understanding the financial statements you're looking at, or financial report as the case may be, and then also understanding the company you are looking at, also returning back to the financial statement elements in the accounts. We will proceed from there subsequently to issues concerning new ratios and how to compare ratios within companies and industries. So let's start by saying that it is important for us to have good knowledge of elements of accounting when we are dealing with financial statement analysis. If you need to understand, if you understand what a financial statement is presenting to you, beginning first from the financial position statement, it'll go a long way in your ability to get the good financial analysis that you desire to make. Now, let's talk about some elements, assets, liabilities, and equities, as you'll find in a typical financial statement position. And just briefly take us through the ways we can observe differences across different companies for the same element of account. So let's talk about assets, for instance. I'm picking on two simple current assets. Inventory for an organization may look radically different depending on what nature, what industry you're looking at. So for instance, a food manufacturing industry will have inventory that will have very short shelf life. So they will be talking in weeks, if not days sometimes, in terms of expiry of the inventory, where perhaps it will be worthless, so to speak. And if you compare that to a construction in industry, you will find that the construction companies have got very, very durable, long-term inventory that will take months or years even before you can worry about their expiry or being out of date. Again, a food manufacturing industry will have virtually all the components of inventory, beginning from raw materials to work in progress and down to finished goods. Whereas for the construction industry, you may just have what technical will be the raw material, maybe work in progress, and perhaps no finished goods, because the finished goods get delivered at the point that they are made. Now, looking at the inventory figure, for instance, in these two different companies, you really need to understand what those figures mean, because at the end of the day, the figures might be exactly the same, but they have different components. If we move into the receivables, we will realize that some organizations sell cash, and the receivables for an organization that it's a business to business sale related company will be different in quality compared to a receivable that is for business to customer, retailers, or perhaps individuals, where they give 30 or 60 days credit. So receivables can be different for organizations, depending on their quality. And so seeing a given amount, say maybe 10 million pounds of receivables, doesn't really tell you anything until you understand the nature of those receivables. We can move to from there to liabilities and talk about the fact that some organizations inevitably will have long-term liabilities, and these long-term liabilities are of different nature and sources. We still need to understand the dynamics, the play of long-term liabilities. Some other organizations may be relying fully on trade payables, maybe because of their large scale, or because simply of the nature of their relationship with other organizations. You have to be able to understand clearly what trade receivables mean for that particular organization. And same as equity, you see a capital structure also, say maybe debt and equity relationship, you do not simply conclude that this is good or bad, because it will matter on, one, the stage where the organization is at that time, two, whether it's a short-term structure, and three, whether it's typically the nature of the organization. So a fair understanding of the components of these elements of account, and understanding the nature of element of accounts themselves, will help us to do a good financial analysis. Then we can move on to the profit or loss statement. I mean, if we find out that there's a figure for revenue, for instance, as I mentioned earlier, it may be a cash sales company, and so the quality of revenue is 100% crystal. But if it is an organization that necessarily have to sell on credit, that is maybe non-retail companies, then again, we begin to say what percentage of this good revenue figure is receivables, and what is the quality of those receivables. An organization may not have cost of goods sold, or may not have a lot of it, if it is a service company, for instance, whereas a food processing or manufacturing company will definitely have cost of goods sold. So you need to understand what it's making up the figures that you're seeing, and weigh that against the type of organization that you are looking at. Cost of goods sold may not mean exactly the same thing for the different organizations, and that may affect the value that has been put in the statement of profit or loss. Then you can also worry about what the profit is like. Is this an organization that has high asset value, like, again, we're back to construction companies, whereas we're looking at those values generating depreciation, for instance, at the end of the year, then you expect huge depreciation figure, which is going to be impacting on the profit figure, for instance. When you see an organization that hasn't got a high depreciation figure, it doesn't make them better or worse. It just simply means that we need to say, by nature, this is what is expected for depreciation in relative terms. Then, of course, we look at profit figure, although a lot of competition go into a profit figure, but we will be able to say whether this organization is at its infantry, and if it's at its infantry, is that expectation of a low profit figure or loss position at that for the first few years, or is this company a matured company? Again, we have to relate the profit figure to the stage of the organization. An organization that has passed its maturity and is now looking at an exit position, may be diversifying its investment in different areas, and that will definitely impact on the profit. So at the end of the day, we need to understand the implication of the figures we are looking at and marry them with the organization, which brings us to the next level of what company are we looking at. The company tells us a lot about what we'll expect from the from its financials. And I must present here that typically when we are told that the industry will be a blanket rule to what we expect from the company, it will not necessarily mean the same thing, because different companies in the same industry could have be existing at different levels of growth. For instance, if we were talking, like Sue were talking about the profitability figure earlier, if a company is in its infancy, we don't expect it to be posting the same nature of profit as organizations that have gone far into their maturity stage, especially if there's been huge investments prior to that start of date. Now, we can also worry about what the board is like. Is this a board that is mature, a board that is learning? Are they new? Is it a takeover board? Is this a board that has been tasked with driving the organization into a new direction? Are they keeping to the mission statement? We need to be able to separate all these things, and a good look into what this board position is, the growth stage of the organization, will help us to give a better interpretation of the particular company in relation to other companies in the same industry. At that, the external environment also has got its big impact, and we need to be very conscious of what an external environment presents for a company. So what are the indices, for instance, running through the economy, and what is the typical expectation of the industry? What direction are the competitors tending to at this time? So is there stiff competition? Are people easily able to enter into the business type? So all that will affect how we relate the figures we see to the organization to give us a very good financial statement analysis. There is no financial statement analysis that will exist just looking at the figures. You must be able to relate the figures you see to the organization circumstances, to the industry circumstances, and to the external environment that stays. Of course, we use ratios to help us understand the financial statement changes from period to period that we're looking at, or actually use the ratios as a summary point where we can compare one organization figures to the other. But essentially, we need to understand that ratios in themselves are dead figures. To be able to use them effectively, we must place them against the benchmark, and typically this will be for the organization internally, using the trend past 5 years, past 3 years of what's been happening. And that helps us to say whether they are doing that well today or not, and help us to be able to project what it's likely to be in the immediate future. I must also warn here that the fact that there's been a trend can be affected by, again, if there's been a change of board, if there's been a change of direction, there's been a radical change in business, all that knowledge of a business must come again to be able to help us interpret the figures we are seeing in this current position compared to maybe what it was 3 years ago. What are competitors doing? Is there a stiff price war existing? our competitors making the same nature of profit as the company you are looking at. If we are able to understand what is at play and be able to compare the figures between one competitor and the other effectively, we will be able to present a good financial analysis for our users. So in summary, we must get a good hang of what is at play internally in the company and what is at play externally in the company, to the company, for us to be able to do a good financial analysis. And the skill of having to use your understanding, apply your understanding of the company to the nature of figures you are seeing for that particular organization will be the differentiating factor between a good financial analysis or interpretation of financial statement and the one that is not so good. Thank you. I will be coming back with more in-depth analysis about how the ratios, what the ratios can mean for us in financial statement analysis in the next mini lecture. Thank you.